for one. Hello, hello, hello. Good morning, good afternoon. Hey, y'all, hey. I've been missing, huh? So y'all know the drill, and if you don't, I have a letter. And since I am in my hometown of Dallas, Texas, hello! I have been missing in action because I have been recharging, okay? Because life has been coming at your girl fast and hard. And outside of the bedroom, that's not a good feeling. So, hey, y'all, hey. So, we have a letter, guys. We have a letter, and I figured since I got some free time on my hand. I'm not in the streets today, okay? If you in Dallas and you see me out here, mind your business, okay? Mind your business. Hey, everybody. So, I got a letter, guys, and I figured I would chop it up. Is that okay with you? Okay, we're going to do it. We're going to do it. Hold on. Let me see. I don't have anything that I'm used to having when I'm at home in Charlotte. So when I'm in Charlotte, this is home. Okay, do you see the bitterness and resentment in me toward Charlotte? Okay, because I ain't trying to hide it. Anyway, guys, we have a letter, so let's get into it, okay? Hey, y'all, I found these glasses. Check this out. I found these glasses at this boutique, okay, in Irvine. On Beltline Road. It's like a smaller, more affordable Sam Moon. If you know anything about Sam Moon, if you're from the DFW, then honey, you can't tell me nothing. I think I grabbed like 20 pair of them. So when you see me in these glasses, a variation of them and colors, mind your business, okay? Let me be great. Ah! Okay, so guys, okay, so here's a letter. We've seen it before. And some of you see it and you get it way too late. But let's talk about it real quick. I'm not going to keep you long. I love all you guys. Hey, y'all. Hey. Do you feel my different energy since I'm at home? Since I'm in Dallas, Texas? Oh, Lord. I should come home more often. I feel like I'm a better person when I'm in Dallas. It's because it's better people in Dallas. You know, let me stop. Because, see, I'm from this area, right? I'm from an area where every woman every woman's bringing it, okay? This area, beautiful women come a dime a dozen, okay? It's so many of them out there. The next woman ain't worried about what you looking like, what you got, what you driving, what your house look like. Because in Dallas, baby, everybody got it. Everybody, a girl, oh Lord. Anyway, and I moved my tire behind old raggedy-ass Charlotte. Anyway, okay. So today's letter is, my friend wants me to leave my man. Mm-hmm, you heard it. Today's letter is, my friend wants me to leave my man. Let me turn this down. Okay, forgive me if I'm not as put together as when I have all of my tools in Charlotte. I'm just working with what I got. Okay, so she says, I've been dating this guy for about a month. Let me turn this down. I love cooling the game, but this is too much. I'm gonna silence them. Okay, so here goes, guys. I've been dating this guy for about a month. He's not my usual type, but he's so incredibly kind, loving, and sweet. We have fun together and enjoy each other's company and have a lot in common. One of my close friends and her daughter came with me to his restaurant yesterday for brunch to meet him. Ooh, you know we really feeling the guy when we want our best girlfriends to meet this guy, right? Ooh, I know what that's like. Been there before. Okay. So I was so excited, but noticed the bad vibes from my friend right away. Y'all peep that. Basically, she called me today to tell me to get rid of him immediately because he's too needy, he's clingy, and he's ugly. Okay, okay. He's the chef at the restaurant and presented us specifically prepared foods. He stayed at our table and chatted a few minutes, then would come back to check on us periodically. That means he's attentive, okay? This annoyed my friend. She said she doesn't like eating in front of people she doesn't know, and he was annoying. She said I could do better. That's what she said, guys. That's what she said. She said I could do better. I didn't find him to be annoying. I thought he was sweet to spoil us, and he was so excited to meet her. She also said it was messed up. We got a bill for the food. We were comped the drinks. And I paid for everyone and left a big tip because I felt it was the right thing to do. She told me her and her daughter were making fun of him later that night and commenting on how thin he was. I'm very sad and bummed out and embarrassed. I really don't know what to feel or think. I would appreciate your thoughts on this. So if you're just now tuning in, we got a girl. We got one of our own. We got a good sister that she may have met the one, okay? She may have met her man, her forever, and she's super excited about it. And me being a woman, knowing how when we've done our due diligence and we check at least most of the boxes on the list, now we're ready to tell our friends and family about this guy, which is what she did, right? This is what she did. She told her best friend about this guy who's incredible, who in her words, he's kind, he's loving, he's sweet. He must be related to me because that's all of that. Anyway, she says her and a guy have fun together and enjoy each other's company, and they have a lot in common. So she takes her girlfriend and the girlfriend's daughter with her to meet her guy because she's excited. Her raggedy ass friend and the daughter get to the restaurant only to make fun of the new guy. They're nitpicking. They're calling him ugly. They're complaining about everything. He's too needy. He's too clingy. And all the guy was doing was making sure that they were enjoying themselves. He's attentive. He prepared a special menu for them. And after all is said and done, her friend calls her and tells her, you need to get rid of this guy. So my friend, homegirl, let me tell you something. Don't you get rid of this man. Misery loves company. And sometimes you don't find out what you have in a friend until you get something good, okay? It seemed like you done got a good one, and she may be jealous. Now, I ran this letter by my girlfriend. This is who house I'm staying at while I'm in Dallas. I've talked about her before on the show. I was like, Sherry, blah, 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 blah. I read the letter to her. She was like, well, maybe the girlfriend told her that because the girlfriend has dealt with the guy before and don't want to tell her. I said, well, you know, I can't operate in hypotheticals. She didn't say that, and she didn't say that's what she was thinking. But let me tell you something about a woman that's a jealous woman who only wants you to be happy when she's happy, or wants you to be miserable and lonely like she is. This chick fits the description. How that man looks is none of her business, okay? If he looks good to you, that's all that counts. This is a good man. This is a good man who you described as kind, loving, and sweet. And you want to get rid of him because a raggedy-ass female friend of yours told you he's ugly and he's too needy? Girl, let me tell you something. You better hold on to him, because you'll lose if you keep him and do right by this man. There's no telling where things will go. But if you keep her in your life, I'm telling you where things will go. She's going to run off every good man in your life. She's going to always find something wrong with every good thing that comes into your life because it's not happening to her. And she may not even want the guy. She just might not want you to have a good man. Don't you throw away this man, girl. Don't you throw away this man. Let me tell you what's out here. So I hear in these streets, you don't want to deal with it. You got a guy who's into you, who's trying to show you a good time. And let me tell you about this man of yours that you have described in the letter. He was excited about meeting her. That tells me something about him. That's how invested he is in getting to know you. That you talk so highly of this friend of yours, and he knows how incredibly important she is to you. He not to say that he went out of his way, but he did a good deed by preparing food that he thought the three of you would enjoy. And you say somewhere in the letter that she thought it was tacky, or she didn't like the fact that he didn't pay for the meal. Did she miss the detail that he's a chef at the restaurant? It's not his restaurant. People kill me with this crazy expectation, like money is out here flowing, you know, like rivers, and that it's just coming out of trees and people just got it like that. Why can't people be together and date within their means? That's okay. Even if he doesn't have it like that, that's okay. You want money or you want the guy? You want a good guy, or do you just want a man that can pay for everything that you can't pay for yourself? Or to just add something, more things into your life? I would say keep the guy. Hey, babe, thank you, Taffy Rose. I thank you, much love. I'm sending love and hugs your way because I'm feeling that type of way. I'm home now, I'm feeling, ooh, love. Anyway, please keep the man. Don't you throw away that guy. Let me tell you how many women out here in these internet streets is looking for the guy that will be compatible with them, in addition to treat them good, not play no games, up front, will go that extra mile just to show their interest and be accommodating when they have their friends and family around. Do you know how many women out there are wanting something like that, who are praying to God on a consistent basis to bring their forever guy into their life? And here you are presented with the possibility, and you're gonna let this no good friend talk you out of it, girl. If you keep this woman in your life, that's your choice. I'm not saying to get rid of friends, because then I would be trifling. Okay, don't do that. What I'm gonna need you to do is learn how to separate that life that you have with him from her. Because if you keep her around and keep her involved in the details of the things that are happening with you and for you in this relationship, she's gonna always be the Debbie Downer. She's not happy for you in that area of your life. So learn how to separate it so you can keep both. I'm not into cancel culture, and that applies to, if you follow me, you know, I'm not into throwing away your relationships. Within reason, because I understand it's some trifling sugar honey iced tea going on out there. I know it's some sugar honey iced tea going on out in these streets and in people's home behind closed doors. I'm just saying, girl, I lost my train of thought. Don't you throw away that man. Don't do it. Please don't do it. See where this goes. See where this goes. But I would suggest, let me tell you what I would suggest. You're going to have a conversation with your friend. I would encourage that. When people write into me, I encourage, have the conversation, whether that's the wife, right, the husband, your significant other. I always say have the conversation. This is no different. Have the conversation with your friend and, you know where you're going to go or the results that you want to achieve in having the conversation with her. When you have the conversation, do you want to get to the root of why she said the things that you said? Do you want to, at the end of that conversation, make sure that you have an understanding between the two of you? Do you want to make sure that the friendship is intact? Have an end goal for when you have the conversation with your friend. So that will help you direct the conversation so you don't get sidetracked into some BS about her insecurities and all of this other. Know what you want to talk about. Know the objective, have the conversation. Let her know, you my friend, I have valued your feedback over the years, but honey, you don't get to pick my man. You don't get to pick my man, nor will you get to run him away. This is not that type of party. Girl, you better, I'm telling you, let this one go and watch the next one behind you come and scoop that man up, and don't care how thin he is, and don't care that he didn't pay for the meal that he served you at the restaurant. Did it ever occur to you that special meal that he prepared for you guys at the restaurant maybe came out of his pocket? You said it was specifically prepared for the three of you. Did it ever occur to that friend that this meal that was not on the menu that he prepared for the three of you was money that came out of his pockets? Because you say he doesn't own the restaurant. He's the chef. Did she ever consider that? I did. That's because I try to see the good in it. Girl, I want you to keep your man. You better keep your man. Or when you get ready to get rid of him, let it be for something that you chose to get rid of him. Or you were not compatible, or things were just not working out, or this or that. But don't you lose your man behind some bitter, jealous-hearted, petty, silly friend. Okay? Don't you do it. So, guys, this has been Talk That Talk with Diva Speaks Relationships. My name is AnGala Portorreal, and the second installment of the autopsy series will be airing sometime over the next 3 weeks. Of course, I'm not in Charlotte right now, so production has been halted. So, I'm out here just enjoying my life right now. But I want you to stay tuned and stay connected, please, to the next installment of the autopsy series, which I'm talking about. What caused the death in your relationship? How did your marriage die? Were you attentive, to to whatever was going on? Did you have, I don't know. But you got to tune in and see the next installment. If you didn't catch the premiere of it, it's going to re-air on the Diva Speaks Relationships Roku channel pretty soon. I'm not sure. I'm out here having a good time. Diva Speaks is not really at the forefront of my mind right now. Also, guys, Diva Speaks Relationships talk show will be airing on another Roku channel. RIGTV is going to be carrying some of the Diva Speaks Relationships talk show, the actual talk show. Over the next 4 to 6 weeks, you will see it over there. I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your day. I enjoyed this time with you. I need to check my settings to make sure that people can comment, because I don't see comments. So it may have been something I did. So if you wanted to comment and you weren't able to, charge it to me, but don't charge it to my heart. Charge it to me not knowing what the hell I'm doing when I'm going and setting up stuff, because that's definitely not me. I'm not like that. But you guys enjoy the rest of your day and stay safe out here in these streets. Much love, guys.